Don't make these video export setting mistakes inside Premiere Pro 2023. A lot can happen when you're exporting a video, and it's important to keep in mind your settings as you export your video. So in this video, I'm going to be covering the top mistakes that can happen if you don't set up your settings correctly. The first mistake that might occur when you export your video is actually exporting more than you need to. For example, I have a project pulled up here and I want to export, you know, my finished sequence, but it ends around here. I don't want to export this, you know, leftover footage I have as my B-roll. So how can you fix this? Well, to actually export part of your sequence, you can set in and out points. So just create an endpoint and an out point, and then that section of the video will be exported. To do that, go to the beginning of your sequence, click I on your keyboard, and then navigate to your last frame. I like usually zooming in here, and then click O on your keyboard. That way, when you go to export, just this highlighted region will be exported. The last thing to keep in mind is when you go to export, you want to be sure to change the range from entire source to source in and out. The next mistake that might occur is actually in your encoding settings. When you go to export your video, you want to make sure you set up the correct format. For example, if you're exporting to YouTube, you want to make sure you're under H.264. A lot of people sometimes use QuickTime or maybe even HEVC. H.265, and for YouTube, that's not really needed. I recommend checking out YouTube's recommended uploading and encoding settings, which is down in the video description. It's updated regularly, so I recommend, you know, if you're watching this video in the future, to check in on it if you do upload to YouTube. And just a brief overview, HEVC, High Efficiency Video Codec, H.265, is used for very large files such as 12 8K footage to more efficiently compress it. But you don't really have to select this for normal 1080p or maybe even 4K footage. H.264 is gonna be fine. These next mistakes can help you actually speed up your export of your actual video. When you click the More button, you'll notice that there's a few options here that you can select. First, there's Render at Maximum Depth. Only check this if you work in 10 or 12-bit color, or you do a lot of color enhancements to your video footage. You don't want your computer overworking itself, you know, doing more than it has to actually export your video. The other box you might not have to check is Use Maximum Render Quality. You want to check the box next to Render at Maximum Render Quality when you're actually editing in a sequence that's, you know, 4K, and then you're exporting maybe at 1080. So when you're downsampling on an export, you want to check the box. That way it's maintaining all the pixel values as it compresses it down. Under encoding settings, another section that you might want to check is to be sure that hardware encoding is selected. Software encoding is a lot slower and will lead to longer rendering times. Another common mistake that video editors make is changing the profile. By default, a lot of the presets in Premiere Pro leave the profile on main, but when you export, you want to make sure that you change it to high. If you're curious, I linked to an article by Adobe, and as you can see here, the high profile is for support for most HD devices. Next, let's talk about bitrate. Bitrate's misunderstood a lot of the times, and it can be kind of hard to wrap your mind around. To keep things simple, a simple explanation is CBR stands for constant bitrate. VBR stands for variable bitrate. Constant bitrate means that the value stays the same for the entire video export. Variable means that it will fluctuate depending on how much bits the video needs at a given point in time. What bitrate is essentially how many bits per frame is actually in the final video export. Or in another way of putting it, it's how much data is actually in your video, how much data and information that final exported video contains. And another thing to keep in mind with bitrate is that it affects the file size. So as you can see here, if I drag this all the way up, it's going to dramatically change the estimated file size. Some people recommend just sliding that bar all the way up if you don't have to worry about, you know, how large your file is. But this isn't always the best way to go. Cameras can only shoot at a maximum bitrate, so really your maximum is only as much as your camera can allow. So if you know your camera shoots at only 40 megabits per second, just make it 40. You don't need to actually go past 40. Now 40 is quite high, and for YouTube, you can check out the YouTube recommended, you know, export settings, but I recommend somewhere between 10 and 20. There's a lot of things that I didn't cover in this video, and if you want to learn pretty much everything you need to know about export settings inside Premiere Pro, I did make a live stream covering everything you need to know. Feel free to watch that video right up there. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, leave them down below.